So welcome ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. In this session we try to look at what is reverse osmosis. I think you remember osmosis means flow of solvent molecules from a diluted solution to a concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane. The pressure exerted in this process is called osmotic pressure, which can be measured by applying external pressure that just stops the osmosis. Now at this piston, if you try to apply a higher pressure than the osmotic pressure, then something opposite to osmosis happens, that is solvent molecules from salt water try to gush into fresh water. In this way you can desalinate saline water of oceans and make it fit for drinking. In countries like Kuwait, Iran, Iraq, this procedure is adopted to get to drinking water supply. Now, let us be familiar with some ideas like isotonic solutions. A pair of solutions which have same osmotic pressure are said to be isotonic. For example, a 3% solution of urea and a 9% solution of glucose can have same osmotic pressure. If two solutions are having same osmotic pressure, it means their molar concentrations are same. That is, N1 by V1 must be equal to N2 by V2. Then only they can exert same osmotic pressure. Then they are called isotonic solutions. When somebody suffers from an injury and somebody loses a lot of blood, then the blood pressure in the body drops and there may be a danger that the blood supply to brain may stop, that may lead to coma or death. To prevent that possibility, to build the blood pressure to normalcy again, doctors often give saline. The saline is 0.9% weight by volume NaCl solution. It is isotonic to blood. Hypotonic solution, a solution which is having lower osmotic pressure, lower concentration than a given solution. Hypertonic solution is a solution that has higher osmotic pressure. If people are taking a lot of salt or pickles or they are taking a lot of alcoholic beverages, alcohol will try to drain the water from cells. Therefore, there will be logging of water in between the cells or tissues that generates a kind of puffiness or swelling. This is called as edema. If you try to place a red blood cell in a hypotonic solution that is having a lower concentration than that of cytoplasm in blood, then what happens? Water from the solution gushes into the red blood cell and red blood cell will burst. If you place the red blood cell in a hypertonic solution, the solution which has more concentration, then the water from red blood cell will go into the solution and the RBC will shrink. All this you can see that is called hemolysis. Of course, you should know that plants take up water through osmosis, right? These are certain ideas related to this. And in the previous session, we have seen osmotic pressure is related to the gas rules like same formula, PV is equal to NRT, like pi V is equal to NRT. And you can bring the V left to right. You can say pi V is equal to NRT, you can write it as pi is equal to N by VRT. N by V is nothing but concentration. So pi is equal to CRT, as you can see. The osmotic pressure of a solution of 300 K is 0.82 K. Its concentration will be. From this relation, C is equal to pi is equal to CRT. You can work out C is equal to pi by RT. So C is equal to pi osmotic pressure value by R, universal gas constant 0.0821. into temperature. So this is a simple problem. Thank you for watching this. And we come out with real many problems after a small discussion on Wontoff factor. In the next session, I talk to you about Wontoff factor. Then we go to reals. That is, we try to solve as many problems as possible. Thank you very much. God bless you.